Hi everyone, this is Will from Optometric Insights, and I wanted to talk to you today about a topic called My Organized Optometry. So around the end of fourth year, every conversation tends to be the same. You know, people congratulate you, but they always ask you the same question. Where are you going to practice after graduation? It's a good question, you know, and it actually takes me back to when I was a first year. And I had the opportunity to attend the Exchange, Vision Source's annual conference. And I had the chance to meet some of the most incredible, bright, successful doctors in the profession from all over the country. I had a lot of really good, great, deep conversations with many of them. But there is one conversation in particular that stands out. You know, one of the doctors asked me, you know, where I wanted to practice after graduation. I was a first year then, but it's still a pretty common question that you get used to answering as a student. I'm from California, and I'm open to the possibilities and opportunities around the country, but I'll likely practice in California, at least to start off. Now, most of the time, that answer is pretty good, and it's good enough, but this particular time, that doctor, he gave me a weird look. He said, "Why would you want to be in California? There's so many optometrists there already, and you can't really do as much there either. I mean, sure, it has great weather and really nice beaches for surfing, but you could go somewhere else and where you can do more. You know, go to a better state where you can take advantage of all that training that you've done and practice at the highest scope. You know, to be honest, it's kind of a waste to be in California." Well, he had some fair points. I mean, and I do encourage everyone to do your research and know exactly what you can and cannot do in each state. Now, back then, I didn't really know how to respond to him when he said that to me, but I kind of wish I had the opportunity to talk to him again after, you know, a few years, because, you know, I do know how I would respond now. To me, if every doctor just moved to the states that already had the highest scope of practice, there wouldn't really be anyone left to advocate and fight for what's right and to bring each individual state up to a higher level of practice. You know, for me, this is why I joined AOA and why I'm a key person for COA, the California Optometric Association. It's why I go to DC, it's why I go to Sacramento every year, and it's why I regularly go visit the offices of my local legislators in their home districts, just keep them informed. You know, it would be easier to just go to states where others have already done the work. But California is my home. You know, right now it's where I choose to work, it's where I choose to live, and where I choose to eventually raise a family. There's 100 reasons to be involved in organized optometry, and you'll figure out exactly what, you know, why you want to be involved. And really, you can do it for the profession, you can do it for your patients. But ultimately, you'll come to realize that the best reason to do it is for yourself. Whichever state you eventually choose to call your home, it's your life. It's your livelihood, and no one will care or fight for it harder than you will. Thanks for listening.